A warm welcome to all of you on this YouTube channel, English Mania. If you haven't subscribed the channel, please subscribe it now. So this is the second part of the lesson 4.1 History of English Drama, which is there in your 11th class textbook. In this video lecture, I will give you a brief introduction of English theater, difference between Elizabethan and Restoration theater. Then we will move on to modern theater and Indian theater. And at the end of this video lecture, we will see different periods in history of English drama. So let's begin this video lecture with a brief introduction to English theater. So English drama was introduced to England by the Romans. Auditoriums were constructed across the country. By medieval period, the mummers plays had developed with the Morris dance. They concentrate on themes like Saint George and the Dragon and Robin Hood. Actors traveled from town to town. Plays with Christian themes were performed at religious festivals. So drama has its origin in folk theater. और उसके बाद में हमने इसमें देखा कि जो English drama आया था वो Romans के through आया था. Because there is evidence to believe that when the Romans were in England, they established vast amphitheaters for the production of plays. But when the Romans departed, their theater departed with them. Okay, so then there were minstrels. People enjoyed their performances. Gradually, by the 10th century, the ritual of the plays that itself had something dramatic in it got extended into the rudiments of a play. So between 13th and 14th century, we see drama started having themes which were separated from religion. The words themselves were spoken in English. A longer dramatic script came into use, and they were called as miracle plays. Later, these religious dramas were the morality plays. We will see in this video lecture, in which characters were abstract वाइसेस एंड वर्च्यूज. सो दीज वर एलिग्रीज. और इसमें होता क्या था कि एक्टर्स जो है टाउन टू टाउन परफॉर्म करते थे, और मोस्टली जो थीम होती थी वो क्रिश्चियन थीम होती थी, जिसमें सेंट जॉर्ज, ड्रैगन एंड रॉबिन हुड, ये सारी थीम्स वहाँ पर होती थी. नाउ वी विल सी द बिगनिंग ऑफ द ड्रामा इन इंग्लैंड. सो 1500 टू 1660, दैट इज इंग्लिश रेनेसा पीरियड. सो इट इज द फ्लावरिंग ऑफ द ड्रामा, वी कैन से. Now 16th century morality play Everyman. So the writer of Everyman is anonymous. किसने लिखा है writer वो नहीं पता. And the earliest comedy in English, Nicholas Sudall's Ralph Royster Doyster. सबसे पहली comedy जो थी English में वो writer Nicholas Sudall ने लिखी थी, जिसका नाम था Ralph Royster Doyster. And the anonymous Gammer Gurton's Needle. उसके बाद में यहीं पे रेनेसा पीरियड में ही वी विल सी हिस्ट्रीज, कॉमेडीज एंड ट्रेजेडीज. और इम्पॉर्टेंट प्ले राइट्स जो है, इम्पॉर्टेंट ड्रामेटिस्ट जो है इस पीरियड के, वो है विलियम शेक्सपियर, क्रिस्टोफर मैरलो, बेन जॉनसन एंड जॉन वेबस्टर. नाउ वी विल सी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एलिजाबेथन एज एंड रेस्टोरेशन एज. सो एज वी हैव जस्ट सीन मॉरलिटी प्लेज, सो दीज सेक्युलर मॉरलिटी प्लेज हैव डायरेक्ट लिंक्स विद एलिजाबेथन प्लेज. ओके. And the Renaissance imposed a learned tradition, classical in depth, with themes of education, general moral problems and secular politics. So the plays had nothing to do with religion now. Okay, so we will see the difference. So Elizabethan age was creative, while on the other hand Restoration period was critical. Drama in Elizabethan age was spontaneous and original. And in Restoration, drama was artificial and imitative. Imitative means copied. Comedy at its height is creative, while on the other hand, in Restoration period, comedy at its best is imitative of the fashions and follies of the beau monde. The Elizabethans were fond of blending tragedy with comedy. जब tragedy और comedy को mix किया जाता है, उसे कहते हैं tragic comedy. लेकिन रेस्टोरेशन जो है वो लोग सेपरेट करते थे कॉमेडी एंड ट्रेजेडी को. दे अडेप्टेड फ्रीली मटेरियल्स फ्रॉम वेरियस सोर्सेस. एलिजाबेथन्स अलग अलग सोर्सेस से अपने ड्रामा की थीम्स को, मटेरियल्स को अडाप्ट करते थे और यहाँ पे रेस्टोरेशन जो है वो बोरो करते थे. नाउ वी विल सी द पब्लिक थिएटर ऑफ द 16th सेंचुरी. ओके, सो द पब्लिक थिएटर ऑफ द 16th सेंचुरी डिफरेंट इन मैनी इंपॉर्टेंट वेज फ्रॉम द मॉडर्न थिएटर. इट वॉज ओपन टू स्काई विदाउट आर्टिफिशियल लाइटिंग. द स्टेज वॉज अ रेस्ड प्लेटफॉर्म विद द रेसेस एट द बैक सपोर्टेड बाय द पिलर्स. There was no curtain and the main platform could be surrounded by on the three sides of the audience. Around the theater there was galleries. Okay, in the 17th century we see the enclosed theater gained importance. There was increasing attention to scenic device as theater became private. Now we will see Shakespearean era. So Shakespearean era came into existence in the 16th century to the public theater. Shakespeare wrote for the contemporary theater, manipulating the Elizabethan stage with great resource and invention. But the genius of Shakespeare should not allow the rest of the drama of his age to be obscured. Contemporary to him was Ben Jonson, a classicist, a moralist, and a reformer of drama. In comedy, Jonson's genius is found at its best and his influence was considerable. The Restoration dramatist leaned strongly upon him. And we will see Thomas Kyd. So Thomas Kyd discovered blank words in drama. Okay. And it was actually Thomas Kyd who discovered how easily blank words might be converted into a useful theatrical medium, which Shakespeare used brilliantly in all his plays. So tragedy developed in the hands of Thomas Kyd and Christopher Marlowe, and comedy had also proceeded beyond rustic humor. But by the 90s of the 16th century, actually, the theater in England was fully established, but complicated conditions governed the activities of the dramatist. Now we will see closing of theaters by the Puritans in 1642. Okay, so it brought this greatest of all periods in the history of English drama to an end. And with the civil wars, no theater existed between 1642 to 1660. 1642 से 1660 तक के कोई भी थिएटर नहीं था क्योंकि सिविल वॉर्स हो रही थी. और बंद जो हुए थिएटर वो प्यूरिटन्स ने बंद किए थे 1642 में. ओके, एंड द नेक्स्ट फेज विच अपीयर्ड आफ्टर द रेस्टोरेशन प्रोड्यूस्ड अ वेरी डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ ड्रामेटिक लिटरेचर. Dramatists like Chapman, Thomas Middleton, Webster, Dekker were at the forefront. सो 1642 से 1660 तक थिएटर क्लोज रहे, लेकिन जब चार्ल्स द सेकेंड आया तो विद द रेस्टोरेशन ऑफ 1660 तो तब 1660 में थिएटर्स वर रीओपन, डबल से ओपन हो गए. द रेस्टोरेशन कॉमेडी अचीव्ड इट्स पिक्यूलियर एक्सीलेंस. अब रेस्टोरेशन कॉमेडी बहुत ज़्यादा प्रोग्रेस करने लगी. ड्रामा डेवलप्ड इनटू क्लास ड्रामा विथ अपर क्लास इथोस. It lasted beyond this period into the first decade of the 18th century. Comedy in the early 18th century declined into sentimentalism. Comedy became comedy of manners, means a sentimental comedy became comedy of manners. George Etheridge was its most important exponent, as I have mentioned here also. And from such depths of drama was rescued by Oliver Goldsmith and Richard Sheridan. Okay, and with Richard Sheridan, something of the brilliance of Restoration dialogue returned into comedy, but with more genuine atmosphere. The characters were firmly presented with clarity, reminiscent of Johnson, but with no depth of Sheridan's world. No new interpretation of human nature. In this, he was nearer to Oscar Wilde than to Johnson. Now let's move on to modern theatre. So this is means modern theatre is the period of theatre that we are currently in. It dates back to the late 1800s. The Industrial Revolution was on its way at that time. There were huge advancements. City life grew exponentially. The intellectual revolution was taking place. Now we see different types of movement in modern theater. All isms were there, like realism, naturalism, anti-realism. Anti-realism has futurism, dadaism, impressionism, expressionism, constructivism, surrealism. This is for your knowledge only. It is not mentioned in your textbook. I am trying to give you every minute details of different types of movement and about modern theaters. So most important part of most important actually characteristics of modern theater is realism. So the most popular and longest standing movement of modern theater is realism. It has a likeness to life without any abstractions. Problems of real life in a realistic manner of a play is mentioned. Realism is a reaction against romanticism, actors becoming the character. The protagonist rises up against all the odds. Realism theater sets, costumes and props were made to mirror their real life counterparts. So this was realism. So realism was popularized by the writer named Henrik Ibsen. He was a Norwegian dramatist. See George Bernard Shaw. He created a comic realism and addressed issues like prostitution, poverty, and slum landlordism. Anton Chekhov created deeply complex relationships between his characters. We will see epic theater. Again, it is not mentioned in your textbook. Epic theater was developed by Bertolt Brecht, aimed at intellectual rather than emotions in order to affect social change. Episodic in nature, cover a great deal of time and change locations frequently. Complex plots and large cast are there in epic theatre. Audience are alienated from the action on the stage. Now we will see theatre of the absurd because it comes under modern theatre. A small unorganized movement in the 15th and 60s. Absurdist playwrights believe that our existence is futile, means useless and nonsensical. Nothing seems to happen in the play. The plot moves in circles. No climactic action or episodic plot. The characters are not realistic. Settings are sometimes unrecognizable. Characters fail to communicate effectively. So this is all about theater of the absurd. Now we will move on to the important part, which is there on page number 133 in your English textbook of 11th class. It is there that earliest seeds of modern Indian drama can be found in the Sanskrit drama. From the 1st century AD, Mahabhasya by Patanjali provides a feasible date for the beginning of the theatre in India. And the major source of evidence is a treatise on theatre. Natya Shastra by Bharat Muni is the most complete work of dramatology in the ancient world. It gives a mythological account of the origin of the theatre. Modern Indian drama, however, has influences from all over the world, as well as Sanskrit and Urdu tradition. So this is all about Indian theatre, a very short introduction of Indian drama or Indian theatre. Now, I must mention T.S. Eliot. He was a very famous writer. Because T.S. Eliot experimented with Greek tragedy in the early 40s of the 20th century, एंड अदर ड्रामेटिस्ट ऑफ द मॉडर्न ईरा जॉन ऑसबॉर्न रोट ऑन द पीपल हु ग्रू अप आफ्टर द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर. सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर वॉज एंडेड इन 1945. सो किंग्सली अमिस इज ऑल्सो अ फेमस राइटर. तो ही रोट अबाउट फ्रस्ट्रेटेड एंटी एस्टेब्लिशमेंट यंग पीपल. दिस ऑल कम्स अंडर मॉडर्न थिएटर मॉडर्न ड्रामा. ओके एंड मैनी नेम्स आई डिड नॉट मेन्शन इन मॉडर्न थिएटर लाइक मॉडर्न ईरा ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स एंटन चेको बर्टोल्ड ब्रेख्ट यूजीन ओनील आर्थर मिलर टेनेसी विलियम यूजीन यूनेस्को सैमुअल बेकेट एंड हैरोल्ड पिंटर. Now we will see history of drama and different periods in history. Okay, so there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 important periods in the history of English drama. First is medieval period, then comes Renaissance period, then third one is Restoration period, fourth is Victorian period, fifth is modern period, and last one is postmodern era. So we will see medieval period starts at 11th to and end at 15th century. So 11th to 15th century medieval period, it was the reign of Henry the Sixth. And the types of plays we have in medieval period were didactic plays, mysteries plays, miracle plays, cycle plays, morality plays. And classics plays are Robin Hood by Howard Pyle and Everyman. Everyman is unknown. The writer is anonymous. We don't know who wrote Everyman. It was a morality play. Then Renaissance period, 1600 to 1700. It was the reign of Elizabeth I and James I. Types of plays we have in Renaissance period were tragicomedy, means a mixture of tragedy and comedy. Melancholy and revenge plays. And plays, classic plays were Romeo and Juliet, that was a tragedy. A Midsummer Night's Dream, that was a comedy. Henry the Fourth, historical play, it was written by, means Romeo Juliet, Midsummer Night's Dream and Henry the Fourth were written by Shakespeare. Then we have Dr. Faustus and Jew of Malta by Christopher Marlowe, Duchess of the Malfi by John Webster, The Changeling by Thomas Middleton. So these were very, very famous dramas of Renaissance period. Then we see Restoration period, 1660 onwards. It was the reign of Charles II. So types of plays we have in Restoration period were heroic drama, pathetic drama and Restoration comedy. Okay. Then classic plays we see All for Love, that was a tragedy by John Dryden. The Way of the World, that was a comedy by William Congreve. These two were very famous classic plays in Restoration period. Then we see Victorian period. 1837 to 1901, it was the reign of Queen Victoria. And types of plays we see, all types of plays were performed in this particular period, that is Victorian period. And classic dramas we see The Importance of Being Earnest by Oscar Wilde, Candia by G.B. Shaw, George Bernard Shaw, A Doll's House and Enemy of the People. These two plays were written by Henrik Ibsen. So these are the classic plays of Victorian period. Then we see modern period. Types of plays we see stream of consciousness, absurd plays, poetic dramas, radio drama. That all come under modern period. Then classic plays we see Pygmalion by George Bernard Shaw and Murder in the Cathedral. This was a poetic drama by T.S. Eliot. And last one we see postmodern era, that is 1945 to 2000. Types of plays we see almost all types of dramas were performed. किचन सिंक ड्रामा वॉज वेरी फेमस एंड क्लासिक प्लेस वर लुक बैक इन एंगर बाय जॉन ऑसबर्न एंड वेटिंग फॉर गोडो बाय सैमुअल बकेट. दीज टू वर इम्पॉर्टेंट क्लासिक प्लेस. जस्ट रिमेंबर सिक्स इम्पॉर्टेंट पीरियड्स इन हिस्ट्री: मिडिवल पीरियड, रेनेसा पीरियड, रेस्टोरेशन पीरियड, विक्टोरियन पीरियड, मॉडर्न पीरियड एंड पोस्ट मॉडर्न पीरियड. अगर आपको ये सीक्वेंस याद नहीं होता है तो आप सिंपली ऐसे याद रखिए MRR VMP. एम से आपको याद रहेगा कि मिडिवल है, MRR मीन्स रेनेसा, देन कम्स रेस्टोरेशन, देन कम्स विक्टोरियन, मॉडर्न एंड पोस्ट. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. आई होप यू हैव गॉट वॉट एवर आई हैव टॉट यू इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर. यू कैन फॉलो अस ऑन फेसबुक, लाइक, शेयर एंड कॉमेंट. कीप सपोर्टिंग मी, कीप लविंग द चैनल. Do share and like. Thank you so much.